This is a Lumitone clock radio from about 1972-73. And say, it don't look like anything special. Looks like a pretty big old clunky clock radio. Well, heck. Let me plug it in and show you what's so neat about this little guy. My volume pot is bad. Anyhow, it's digital. Well, it's a mechanical digital. This actually uses a rotating discs and backlighting for the digital clock. Well, I guess we're not just going to be able to, just not going to be able to hear the radio. Oh, there it changed. Oh, that's the alarm buzzer. Oh no, the snooze don't work. Well, anyhow, while I've been preoccupied with the lousy volume control, you know, the real neatest thing about this clock is the clock. If we go to set the time, let's see, 3, I'll turn it slow, it goes into 4, and we're going to go into 5, and 6. I wonder why it's up. There it goes. Hopefully we're going to set it in there. Sure, pretty neat. I'm going to turn the set to off, and it doesn't seem to have any effect. Might be a little clutch in there or something that's gummed up. Probably can't see it, but setting the alarm is just flipping by 10-minute increments on this switch, and then by hour on this one. No AM or PM provision. There's a snooze button. On the side, we got an earphone jack, and you just your standard controls.
These things bounce all over the place.
I'm not mistaken.
Longhorns right now.
Yeah. Let's cut these fluorescents off. Oh, there went the volume. Let's cut off the fluorescents. And see if we can't pick up something, how good this radio is.
Each go hit it out.
So there you go. 2-run bomb, 4-2.
690. No WSM.
Onside.
LSU, start.
No, we definitely need to clean it up. Got it.
Wait, did she want the money to hide?
It allows you to adjust.
Thank you.
stale, melted ice cream going.
It's only 3:30 p.m. I'm talking.
And they recommend Hydralyte.
Well, I thought it was a pretty neat thing. Turn the radio off. Lumitone, I believe on the bottom here. Oh yes, we do have all the labels. This thing was incredibly dirty when I got it. And of course the light's going to wash it out for y'all, but this was made by Tamera Electric Corporation in Japan. It's a model R111. Walnut veneered top and end panels, and to prevent fire or shock hazard, do not expose this appliance to rain or moisture. Very important. Please do not dump it in the bathtub. But I'm really not set up to taking stuff apart anymore. But one day I'll open it up and demonstrate the mechanism. Just something unusual, something you're not going to see anymore. Well, all right.